had a meeting about the rocket.
Yeah, we had a rocket meeting. We had an executive rocket meeting.
I think we really need to start again with this.
Yeah, this is not on. No. We didn't have any sort of separators, so we had to go side by side. It served its purpose, don't get me wrong. But the P1 has had three iterations. It's time to P2 it.
Yeah.
For a new probe, a completely P2. Fresh design. We're still going to use the Probodobodyne Octo.
Yep.
Again, it looks slightly flashier than it did before now. I'm going to zoom right in. A little thing I like to do, I never explain myself and I do this all the time,
okay,
is when you start on the runway, you're automatically facing north.
Yes.
But the most efficient way to get into an orbit is to head west straight away.
Okay.
So just out of habit, I flip it round. And I think it's now supposed to be this way around. This way is like the front. So when we take off, we'll now be facing outwards on the runway. We
right,
head,
I'm with you.
All we have to do now is pitch our nose down rather than to turn left or right. If
in a rocket.
It makes sense in my head.
Yeah.
Right. What we also need to do now... Oh, we don't have... What we don't have is a parachute, right? Because I have yet to get survivability.
Have we got enough for that?
But we don't, because I've used all my science. But what I can do is I can build something with an aerial, beam back some science.
Yes.
And hopefully
we've been beaming back quite well.
Yes. I mean, this thing's going to blow up. Don't get me wrong. But that's fine for now, because you know shit happens. Oop. So we put a nose cone on there, and then. We can also put a service bay underneath, so we can have some equipment in there.
Some cheeky science beam back.
Some cheeky science equipment. Even though this thing's going to blow up, we are sort of future-proofing it.
Okay, because this is a design that we might carry over.
It's a design we might carry over.
Even though we can test some parts on this, see how things work.
Exactly, and all we need to do is pop a parachute on the top when we get it to make it returnable, and put a heat shield on the bottom. So that's... We're just going to concentrate on the rocket for now, and we'll come back and put all the science jiggy on the end.
This is the bit you want to see.
Yeah, this is the bit. This is the big boy. So what we don't have at the minute... What's this? Ooh.
Wow.
I didn't realise. There's a different type of engine for the plane. We could try those as well. What we really need here is a dashend. So this is a liquid fuel engine.
Okay.
So this is going to be a variable engine. So the ones we had before were solid rockets. So we just hit spacebar and the rocket flew off. But this is going to be a variable engine. It doesn't have what they call gimbal, so we're not going to be able to steer the rocket off the engine. But we can do that with fins and stuff, so that's not too much of a problem. So, but they need obviously fuel tanks. So we're going to pop one of these in. We're going to just go straight for the biggest one.
It's a bad boy.
It's a big bad boy rocket. The big one's big.
That is big.
That is quite big, isn't it? Have we got a thinner fuel tank? Well, we can't change the size of that one. Can we attach that and then scale that down?
Okay.
We can.
Yeah.
We can do that. That's absolutely fine.
Another one of those?
I think we'll be okay for now.
Okay.
What it does mean, we are going to have to scale this engine down.
Yeah.
I said I didn't want to scale engines up. I don't mind scaling them. Oh, I can't scale this one down.
Oh, okay.
So what we're going to do, that's okay, we will just tweak this design slightly, and we're going to put an adapter on.
Okay, yeah.
To put it up to the next size. So that's absolutely fine. And then we can whack one of these big fuel tanks on.
It's a bad boy. Looks like a missile.
Now it looks like a... It does look like a... This looks like some sort of warhead.
Intercontinental.
Ballistic missile.
Is this the war project for the Kerbals?
Yeah.
A break from science, plane.
Considering this has not got a parachute on the top as well. Yeah. You're right. Yeah, this looks... So we're going to bring this down here to ground level. So I like to build, from the ground up. So that's going to be like... The length of the rocket, I think. I don't think it needs to be any bigger or taller.
How are we going to launch it? Is it launched with that, or are you going to have side
We're going to have booster rockets. So what we do need is we're going to have some tail fins, but I want ones that have got...
You've got a good selection, isn't
it? We've got sort of lots of parts here, yeah. That's tail fin. I don't think we've got Oh, here it is, the Delta Deluxe Winglet. So this has control surface. So you can see it's got a lot of little flaps at the back.
So is that going to help us pilot it?
This is going to help steer the rocket, yeah. Because
especially because the engines...
The engines can't on its own, no.
That's sexy.
Oh, they are sexy. They are nicely tapered as well. And then on the sides here, we're going to attach... I'm hoping we've got our coupling. We don't have any side couple. We don't have anything to couple on the side at the minute.
Okay.
So we can't have boosters. That's a bit of a problem. I mean, we could have boosters, we just wouldn't be able to ditch them once they're empty.
I don't know, maybe just try that. I mean, that's pretty sleek. Build some science into the antenna.
Let's just fire this and see how high it gets.
Maybe, do you want some like fuel intakes, just to keep it cool?
No, we don't need to worry about overheating yet. That's we're going to be absolutely fine on that.
We need a transmitter.
We do need
a battery.
A transmitter.
Need a battery for this one? Is that going?
How many parts we got? Yeah, we're gonna need a battery, because it's we don't want it to run out of juice. Oh, we don't want three. In fact, what we'll do is we'll.
That's pretty neat.
We'll stick two on the side of the bit that we're gonna ditch.
Yeah.
We're gonna ditch that bit.
Just we gotta make sure to send the information.
Yes. Yes. In fact, I've thought about. I've had a.
You can map that.
I've had a brainstorm, Matt.
Have you? Good.
I've had a brainstorm. It's not the most efficient. It's not going to be an extremely efficient rocket, but just to get a bit of extra height, considering this rocket is non-returnable, right? What we're going to do is at this stage here.
You're going to put another rocket.
I'm going to put one of these rockets. So they are quite big. I think there's one. The cricket, there we go. Is that not... Oh, we can't attach to the bottom of a cricket.
Is there another attachment?
Can we put the bottom on one of them? Oh, we can go on one of them, though.
Yeah.
There we go.
That's a mean ship. We might have to see if it flies.
Oh, it's definitely going to fly.
Yeah.
I'm a bit worried about the wobble. It might wobble a bit, but I'm hoping it doesn't wobble. Right, we do need to... do we put the communicators on? Yeah, we put the communicators on.
Because we're going to have this manned at some point, so it's worth seeing if we can...
The communicator can
they
go...
They need to really be up there now.
Up on this this rocket stage here.
That's sleek.
You're right about the...
Battery.
What we can do, just for aesthetic reasons, is rather than putting a battery up in there, we can put a battery up in there, like a battery as a lighter.
Yep, that's cool.
And then... We go to our science stuff. Just do one of these. Kerbal Engineer.
Give us that extra data.
Yeah, and then we can put some experiments up in here. Accelerometer. The barometer.
Nice. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to this. I'm intrigued by the new engines. I mean, the new engines on the plane. Yeah,
this
so
bit's
well.
A bit experimental.
Yeah.
Oh, we can also. This is fantastic. Oh, they're quite big though. How's this going to fit in?
Just there.
We might need a bit.
I think that might be a future experiment.
What, the magnetometer boom?
Yeah, it's big.
It is big, yeah. Let's wait for
let's
wait for the magnetometer. How big's that? That's quite chunky as well. So we'll wait until we've got a bigger payload coming back for those. And I think that's probably everything. Electrical, utility. I mean, we could take a camera up there.
We didn't really use the camera.
We didn't really use the camera that much, yeah. And it's a bit of a shitty camera at the minute, to be honest. We don't need a lamp or anything attached, do we?
No.
No, everything's fine there.
It's going to blow up.
What?
It's going to blow up.
Oh, it is going to blow up, that's true. Yeah, okay. I think that's everything for now, to try and get some cheeky science from up in the sky.
But it's a good test flight, unmanned.
Should this little rocket need...
I can see how we can add to it.
Does this tiny little rocket need tiny little fins?
You think? In fitting with the others? That's quite sleek.
I don't want it to look left out.
Yeah, it can't hurt. Might get a bit of wobble at the front.
Yeah, might keep the stability at the top.
Seems to fit in. It's
trying to think if there's anything.
It's quite bee-esque.
Ooh, I like that. Yeah. Should we call it the wasp? I think we've already got a bumblebee. The P1 was the bumblebee.
So this could be the wasp work.
Oh, this could just be like another type of bee. This could be like the P2. I don't know. I'll keep doing this. P2.
Queen bee.
Oh, I like that. Queen bee. Outer space. Queen bee.
Because if it becomes like our first really good rocket, it'd be like the old one.
Yeah.
The old reliable queen bee.
Just the old Proby, the old Proby Doby Dime.
Got the old engines.
It does. We just need to go into the old boring bit, the custom action groups, just assign.
You don't worry too much about engines for this one, do you?
No.
Except you can control. No, you can't.
I can control the first stage engine, but not the second one. My hope is that the liquid engine, I can get it up to a reasonable height, and then just fire this one off and just straight up. Yeah, it's not.
Shoot the side.
It might not do any good. It's like it's not. It might not get us any higher than we're not.
What do you want? You got battery. Do you want the solar panels?
We don't. I don't think we've got solar panels unlocked yet.
Okay.
It will gain some power back from the accelerational thrust that will be converted in. But
okay.
It'll be when we get solar panels. Yes. It's also not probably going to be alive long enough to really utilise a solar panel.
Yeah.
It's just going to be slung up into space.
All right. Well, best of luck, sir.
Thank you, sir. Oh, we could have probably put launch clamps on it, but...
Okay.
No.
It's a sleep machine.
It is a sleep machine. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Blast off. Why was the countdown? And why? I did install a countdown mod.
I think so.
But it seems to have not loaded up properly. Never mind. Yeah. Let's go.
Oh, off we go. Blow me.
Oh, I like that end. Those engine effects are nice.
That's got some up my side. We could go to the moon.
Yeah, we have. We can kill some speed now. We've got to that. As long as we keep a G of acceleration, I'm happy. So we're down to
pretty sleek.
2 G's of acceleration there. Because we just want to get the most fuel efficient lift as possible.
Yeah. I could see a curve overtaking this.
Oh, yeah.
There's a launch.
That was a really nice and smooth launch, straight up.
Really good. Seems to be like going a good steady speed.
Yeah, it's picking up acceleration nicely. It's sitting just above that 1G. It's about 1.5G acceleration.
It's doing what I'd like it to do.
Yeah, so
imagine it's quite heavy. That's the thing.
It is quite heavy, and obviously it's got this solid rocket fuel above.
Yeah.
Now see at the bottom on all these numbers that we talked about earlier. Some of the ones are kind of not that important to us, but some of the ones that we need to keep an eye out is stuff like apoapsis height, which is the top number there, and that is the peak of our jump. So 70,000 meters is considered space. So as you've seen, we've just surpassed that.
Just broke that.
So as we could literally cut fuel now, and we'd have enough to get into space. Like we're already going to get there, 90,000 meters. So actually, when we fire,
should we get some research? Should we turn the engines off and do them again?
Oh, when we get higher.
Like, do some science, or... Because we're going to get some force from these.
Mm-hmm.
We've probably got quite a bit of fuel still, I imagine.
I think this is one of the mods. So, yeah, I think one of the mods is giving me engine delay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so there we go. Yeah. We have engine delay. So my engines don't just cut out straight away like they do.
Of course, no.
So, yeah, look, now we are in space.
Yeah.
We're actually going to be able to get quite far away. I think we're going to. I think we might sling this little probe extremely far.
Should we go to the moon?
I don't know if we'll be able to get to the moon because it's not going to be a controlled sling. But bear with me. We're going to log some temperature data.
Get some science.
And get some nice science there. We're also going to log some pressure data. And get some more science there. We are also looking at our apoapsis. So our apoapsis is still going up. So we're going to get to about 140,000 meters away. And then what I'm going to do is when I get there, I'm just going to keep going in a straight line as far away from the Earth.
Yeah.
Because if we can get
still
fast
got that
enough,
much of your main rocket to go.
Yeah. In fact, let's just burn here because we need to keep the speed going.
Yeah.
Right?
So really break.
If we can get a ridiculously high speed going and see how quick the speed goes up, right, we might be able to ditch that and go for the second one. Whoa. And this is going to burn for a good while. It's going to burn for a good few seconds. I don't think we're going to do it. It's not got a big of impact. Because this sort of rocket is not very efficient in space at delivering thrust for us. But it's going to send us out this far to 1.15 million miles.
Surely we could get some science.
If that was a bit more of an efficient rocket, we might have just slung off into orbit of the sun. That's what I was semi-hoping. But
we can get some good science.
Yeah, I think we're going to get actually more science from going into what is considered high space now.
Yeah.
This poor rocket has no idea what's coming.
It's been a star. Maybe we'll go back and get it one day.
It's going to come back, mate.
Yeah.
And it's going to crash into the atmosphere. And what we can do from here is we can just speed things up a little bit by hitting the arrow keys. And there we go. Yeah. We are already in more science. And this has got a bit of flavour to it. Look, measuring the temperature of space appears to be quite impossible, as there is no matter around to be either hot or cold, except the spacecraft and the thermometer itself. This is probably going to give an R&D guy something to think about for a while.
4.5 science.
So we can transmit that back. We just need to keep an eye on electric charge and how much it's costing us.
But this is good science.
This is good science. The instrument reads zero. It's as if we're in a vacuum. Another 4.5 science there as well. Thank you very much.
Well done. Science rocket.
Science rocket.
One day science rocket and science plane will merge. We'll get a space plane.
Space rocket plane.
Yeah.
So we also got Escape the Atmosphere.
Nice.
We got a bit of credits for that, 18,000.
Good, wow.
We also got some milestones. Yeah. Reaching space, distance record of 100 kilometres, and altitude record of 70.
Still rocking along.
Our altitude's a little bit higher than 70 kilometres, and we plunk back down to the Earth. Has it got an answer? Yes, we can turn it around. Whoa! And it exploded.
We knew it would explode.
About 40,000. But we knew that as an eventuality.
Yeah.
But luckily, we should have now enough science to afford a parachute to bring something back down. Probably not a man yet.
Can you just go straight into parachute? Just bang a parachute on that one and bang it up again?
I think so.
I think that'd be a good plan.
Yeah.
Get that data back. That was some tasty science.
Well, we need to have a look at, because we finished that mission. Yeah.
There must be a mission for parachutes or something.
So we have, we still need to do that one to fly an airplane up. We still need to get a manned altitude. But now...
Move some rockets at the moment. Sessie.
We're going to get a contract to orbit. And this is going to be some big bucks. Like, this is 50,000 Kerbin dollars.
Yeah.
And it's also 10,000 advance. So we're going to take this as well. Because we are going to try and launch something into orbit.
Does it have to be a Kerbal?
No, it can be a probe.
Okay.
It's just anything into orbit. It does not have to be. You know, like I said in the last episode, some of the mods here are based more around unmanned before manned.
Yeah.
So we're just going to try and get some contracts and some cash in before we send that Kerbal up.
And we're keeping manned to our plane program.
That's yes, exactly. Yeah,
they're not ready yet.
They're not quite ready.
Not ready to put a man Kerbal up in.
No.
No, they still need more training. We've only got one pilot.
Yes. Yeah.
Who we trust.
Yes. I'm thinking in a bit we send Valentina up just to do that 2,500 contract to get rid of.
Yeah, okay.
Just here on a routine run.
I think we need a new pilot for the rocket.
But for now we're going to go for R&D. I'm going to take survivability for 16, and this is going to give us the much needed parachutes.
Yeah.
It's also going to give us a heat shield, which is very good. Some solar panels.
Yeah.
Which are much needed as well. Some better antennas, some landing struts, a water tank and a bigger service bay. Brilliant. Yeah, 16 stuff. Points, just what we needed.
Still got some more?
20 is for general rocketry, yeah. Everything's starting to cost more. So this one's 20 and these ones are all 45 now. So we're going to start to need to generate more science. Probably the sensible one to get next.
I think we're generating good science.
Yes.
With what we're doing.
The sensible one to go for next would be basic science. I know we do want the manned capsule, but if we go basic science, it allows us to generate more science.
Yeah.
And it's going to give us stuff like an orbiter telescope. It's going to give us the ScanSat radar, so we can try and get some maps going of Kerbin.
Okay. We can definitely.
Some extendable. We need to go
so
science.
So the rocket program, I think, science as well. Science rocket.
Yes, definitely.
This is how we're going to make science space plane work.
We're going to work overnight to design a secondary rocket.
I think so, yeah.
And
we just put parachutes on that one, or you think we'll go?
Well, there's not. I don't know whether that's not going to get us into orbit.
No, you think we need more rockets?
We need.
Should we have two of those rockets?
Two of those rockets?
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, we can't really steer it.
No. But that's not really the plan, is it?
We need the cup.
Do you want to get into orbit?
That's what we need. Hang on. What we need to get into orbit is decouplers.
Decouplers.
That's right. What we need, right? So here's the plan. Where are decouplers? We get some decouplers for taking basic rocketry.
Yeah.
So we need another 14 science. What's the best way to get 14 science right now? Oh. Forgot about that. the best way to get 14 science is probably, honestly, to go and fly over to the mountain. There's some science over there we could get. We might actually get 14 science from...
What with?
Space plane. Science plane.
Science plane? Yes. Science plane out.
So I think we need to do a science plane run out, actually.
Okay. There wasn't this mentions we wanted to try the science plane. Oh. We could do a test flight.
We could, yeah, we could swap those engines.
Wasn't there some engines you wanted to
What we do is warp to the next morning, because I don't want to fly out at night.
No, not with science plane.
There we go. Go to the space
Good
plane.
Good morning, Kerbals. Well done with morning, yesterday's Kerbals. Flight.
Yes, very successful.
Very successful.
Yes.
We got lots of good science. We got brought lots. You more stuff.
Yep, boy, new got toys
parachute
to play.
Boys. Yeah. Parachutes.
Finally.
Going to put some new engines on the space plane, science plane to celebrate.
On the Kestrel.
I mean, they're good engines, and I thought they worked really well.
Yeah?
I mean, just remember to map your engines.
That's very true, on those ones.
Those ones?
So these ones, yeah. Wow. So this looks like a...
Turbine engines.
So this looks like it's going to fit on the back. Hang on. Yep. That's a back one.
Oh.
Now, obviously, the advantage of a back one is it saves us another part. Because we don't have to have two engines, we just have one bigger engine.
We can hit some speed.
So.
Gotta have fun with it, we gotta practice with this.
Yeah, we do, yeah.
You know, these test flights are for calling Jebediah back off his holiday.
Okay, yeah, this is what I think we do.
Okay.
I think we scrap that.
Yeah.
Get rid of that.
They were good, though. I think they could be an option.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're definitely an option, and we do like these engines. We're gonna need. I think a bit of structural fuselage to bring this plane out a little bit now.
I think so.
I
think it needs to evolve a little bit.
Yeah, in fact, you know what? We're going to do a complete and utter rehaul on this engine.
Okay.
On this design as well. We're going to scrap this wing design.
Really?
Yeah, really. Yeah, really, man. We do need to attach quite a few of these scoops, so that's where we need to save parts on, so we can have intakes, because these ramjet and those pulse jet engines we had, they had intakes in the front, so the scoops and the engines themselves are taking air in. Now, this engine has no intake at the minute, so we need to make sure we've got those going. And what we're going to do... Oh, it's quite long. Do we need that extra fuse? Yeah, I think we probably do, otherwise it looks silly. And I'm hoping the balancing's okay. In fact, we might need to swap over at some point. Take those off for now. We might need to swap these two over.
Yeah.
Depending
okay.
on how the balancing goes. If I was better, if I was better at science, I'd know which one the sensible way to do is.
Yeah.
In fact, I think the fuel at the back makes more sense in my head. Seems like
travels
sense.
Less.
Yes.
Distance.
And we do definitely need one of those on the top. I know that. Definitely need that there.
Yeah.
Right, but what we're going
to now, if we got some new wings and stuff, that's the thing. Because remember the wings put on it, they were sleek.
We're going for delta wings, yeah?
Yeah.
We're going for this sort of design on the wings now? More of like a flat.
I like that.
More of like a flat.
That looks good.
It does look pretty good, doesn't it? It looks nice, mate.
Science planes evolving. It's all that space plane research.
Yeah.
Oh, the rocket.
We can take we'll keep the canards on, but we need to make them a lot smaller.
No, they're signature of this model.
In fact, that's good.
You always have to have them there.
Yeah.
They're like a signature piece, but you can make them smaller.
I'll make them smaller because they're generating too much lift.
Yeah.
About
there you go.
That's absolutely perfect.
No, it's as far as like on, isn't it?
As far as lift is concerned. We also need flight controls on these bad boys, otherwise they will not function as wings.
Pretty sleek.
It does look pretty sleek.
The Kerbal design team.
The Kerbal design team are thoroughly impressed. I'm also thinking.
I think Jebediah would come back for his holiday for this.
Oh, yeah, yeah. 100%.
He'll want in on this. He's flying this. No way, but no two ways about it. So, races of 50 will quite.
So, we've got 7 parts to play with here as well now.
Okay. Well, we've got landing gear on the back. We can get rid
we
of.
We don't
the,
have back landing gear.
I think we can get rid of the camera on the front.
Yeah, that's a part we don't need, really.
Well, we need the scoops.
Because we do need parts spare for scoops, that's true. In fact, let's put the scoops on now. Because we could probably attach landing gears to scoops.
Nice. That's hench.
Should we leave these big hench ones on now?
I bet that will work. That looks like you got that first try.
First try? I think that's already taken by another YouTuber. How about I thought about that?
Balance it out, probably. It looks pretty sleek.
It does look pretty sleek like that, doesn't it?
Oh, it's taking on a.
And then we can have the landing gears. Sort of like. They're going to be. We're going to move them around a little bit.
But that's tested.
Sort of
nicely,
they're sort of
going to
be there. Sort of a mini tip for plane builders, that's budding plane builders. If you
it's
have.
A bit high, you need to bring it down.
Yeah, they're going to come down. You want your wheels. If you have your wheels in front of your rear control surfaces. It means they can pivot, and you can take off your plane pivots on the back wheels.
Yeah.
If these wheels were sort of like all the way back here, the plane would be much harder to take off. Seems to common sense sometimes, but like it's something I didn't realize when I started building the game necessarily. Like what building in the game, not building the game.
Yeah.
I'm not taking credit for this.
So they're okay where they're at now.
Yeah. In fact, I might make these ones the underneath ones.
Yeah.
I might make these.
Could you have the scoops on the wings do it and have different wheels?
What's that, sorry?
No, it's okay, I was being, yeah. No,
oh shit. Oh. I want to move these. In fact, now what am I doing?
Yeah.
I want to make that a bit smaller.
Okay.
And then.
It's not going to harm it, I don't think.
Move that in slightly. Well, it'll get slightly less air out of those ones.
Yeah.
But, that's fine. Yeah. Sort of thing.
They're not in the way so much the wheels.
No.
Of course, yeah.
I think that's absolutely fine as it is like that.
Sleek.
That is pretty sleek, isn't it?
It's going to need a new name.
It will need a new name in a second. We're not quite finished though. We've got 2 spare parts.
A transmitter?
It's got a transmitter on the bottom. It's got all the same signs from the first one. Is that nothing else
we can't get any bigger science in. I've got that bay in the middle, like that empty space. Can we put some big science in there?
We've not got anything really, like the magnetic boom stuff that's retractable.
Yeah.
That extends to a massive boom. Yeah. That's like you use that in space. So we've got nothing really that we can put in there that we need at the minute.
That's fine.
What we could do, we have got 2 parts that we could probably put those the air brakes on.
Air brakes, yeah, well definitely. We're testing out the new engine, it's worth it. If we drop them, we don't, you know.
Oh, we can put them on the
wings. Oh, yeah, put them on the wings. That's no mistake. The Kerbal design team has been really at it this time.
Yeah.
Really proud of the guys.
Oh, yeah, totally, man. And then we'll just
put some wing brakes on the bottom so it's like.
Oh, we've run out. We've got 30, that's 30 of 30.
Okay, that's cool. Oh, it needs a name. It's got a fat bottom.
It does have a fat ass.
It's like a swan.
J-Lo.
Swan.
It's like a swan, yeah.
An ugly little swan.
Actions, 1 second.
Oh, yes.
Just take...
Remember to put engines on.
Take Eric's off that. That's what on there. That's nice.
That should or engine on. On this case.
Toggle engine. Toggle air brakes.
People get really turned on by that bit. They love it.
Yeah. This is... X3 Swan. It's the Swan. It could be rapid though. This denotes feelings. Oh, what we're also going to do.
Is there any contracts going really fucking fast in a plane?
There probably will be in a minute after we do this 2,500 one. We're going to do Valentina Kermit.
No, Jebediah, come back from Valentina needs to, this one.
She needs some experience, mate. We need to be into, we need to make sure that we're not just, you know.
She's got the call up.
She's got the call up, man. This is her big Kerbal call up for the X3. This is her.
Do we need to invest in the runway? How are we doing with money with that?
Oh, no, the runway is absolutely fine for now. Yeah, Steve. We don't need to runway. We won't need to upgrade the runway until we get a really heavy plane now. It's just going to be limited by weight.
Yeah.
The launch pad is something we could possibly look at upgrading, but we need to focus mainly on getting
braces. We could build those ourselves.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, we want to look at upgrading our
first mission. This big experimental plane.
Mission control center.
Yeah.
That's something we need to upgrade.
Okay.
And also the observatory, because we need to be able to perform orbital maneuvers, which we'll get to in a bit.
Ready for new, so new science plane.
Yeah, we're going to go pop over to the mountains and see if we can get some science. Some science.
A bit of a flight practice?
Yeah, a bit of flight practice for Valentina. They were the top of the town, and when the band was playing,